cross seeding or broadcasting seed on top of the ground during the dormant season is not only an effective method for establishing food plot species like clovers, but it also is an effective method for establishing native warm season grass and forb mixtures. On top of that, frost seeding is a great way to thicken up stands of perennial clover that may be old and have thinned over time. Frost seeding relies on the natural freeze-thaw cycle as well as the wet-dry periods of soil to help work the seed into the ground. This helps you achieve the proper planting depth and seed-to-soil contact needed for germination. Frost seeding also helps break the natural dormancy cycle of a lot of our native forb species. One of the major problems when planting small seeds like clovers or native grasses and forbs is burying the seed too deep. Frost seeding on top of the ground ensures that you have the right planting depth, which will aid in germination. Frost seeding is also a cheaper alternative to other methods of establishment, such as no-till drilling or conventional planting, and usually does not require very much specialized equipment. Generally, frost seeding can be done with as little as a hand seed spreader, but you can also use an ATV or a tractor with a mechanical seed spreader. It's not necessary for the soil to be frozen in order to frost seed, but the soil at least needs to be firm enough for the equipment to drive over the surface. We will be going over the equipment that you need to frost seed, as well as how to calibrate the seed spreader. When spreading fluffy seed like native grass and forb mixtures, it's important to use a carrier that will help you ensure that the seed flows well through the spreader and is spread evenly across the field. Carriers can be anything from pelletized lime, soybean meal, cracked corn, wheat, or oats, but you should avoid using any nitrogen fertilizer as a carrier. Today we'll be using pellet lime at a rate of 200 pounds per acre. Generally, carriers are not needed when you're spreading seed like clover. The equipment you need to frost seed could be a tractor, a truck, or an ATV with a broadcast or cyclone spreader. These are typically sold as fertilizer or seed spreaders and could be PTO driven, electric, or pull behind models. Ideally, you would want a broadcast seeder with an agitator that would help you stir the seed as you spread. Smaller areas can be frost seeded with nothing more than a hand seed spreader. The first step in the frost seeding process is calibrating our broadcast seeder. To do this, we need two pieces of information. The first is the effective swath width, or how wide the seed spreader is throwing the seed. The second is how much seed are we spreading over a given area. Once we know these two pieces of information, we can then adjust our rate to match our desired rate. To calibrate the spreader, we need to set up a course, in this case 100 feet, to determine the swath width and the output of the seed spreader. This can be done on a paved area or in the field that you will be planting. We first load the spreader with a known amount of our seed mix, in this case 20 pounds. And while someone is standing behind the spreader, we will spread the mix the length of the course. We will then measure the width the mix would broadcast across the field and weigh the remainder of the mix from the spreader. The difference between the initial weight of the product and the remaining weight is the amount of product we spread over 100 feet. Multiply the swath width, or how wide the seed spreader is spreading, in our case 18 feet, by 100, and that will give us our total area covered. We then divide this number by 43,560, or the amount of square feet in an acre, and that will give us our total area covered in acres. Now you divide the pounds of product that you spread by the area that you spread in acres, and this will give you the calibrated rate of product per acre. You can repeat the process, adjusting your opening depending on if you need to increase or decrease the rate. The seed output is adjusted by increasing or decreasing the size of the opening that is regulated by the seed gate. Most seed spreaders have a chart on the side of the spreader that lists commonly spread materials and the recommended opening size for that material. This serves as a good starting point and a good reference point when you're starting the calibration process, but more than likely you'll have to adjust the seed size opening to ensure that you have the proper planting rate. A good rule of thumb is to calibrate our seed spreader at or just below our recommended planting rate. We can always make multiple passes across the field to use up any extra seed, but if we calibrate our seed spreader too heavy, then we're going to run out of seed before we finish the field. Now that you've calibrated your broadcast seeder, you're ready to seed.